The hadith recorded by Abu Darda, a man comes listening to Abu Darda, Ya Abu Darda, ihtaraka baytuk, oh Abu Darda, your house is burnt. Abu Darda is sitting there, calm and collecting, mahtarak, the house of Abu Darda cannot burn. Another man comes listening to Abu Darda, ihtaraka baytuk, oh Abu Darda, we've told you that your house is burnt. Abu Darda is sitting there, calm and collective, that the house of Abu Darda cannot burn. A third one comes, imba'atatin nar, hatan tahat ila baytik tufiyat, oh Abu Darda, there was a huge fire, it was eating everything that came in its way. But when that fire reached your house, oh Abu Darda, the ajib thing was, we did not put out the fire, the fire went out by itself. Abu Darda replied, قَدْ عَلِمْتُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ لَمْ يَكُنْ لِيَفْعَلْ. Abu Darda knew, and he had such iman yaqeen, that the Almighty Allah will not make it so, and not let it happen, that the house of Abu Darda burns. The world is astonished, the people are gobsmacked. What is Abu Darda saying? He explains that I've heard Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, whoever reads the following words, Allahumma anta rabbi, la ilaha illa ant, alayka tawakkal, wa anta rabbul arshil kareem, ma sha'a Allahu kan, wa ma lam yasha' lam yakun, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-ali al-azim, a'lamu anna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir, wa anna Allah kad ahata bi kulli shayin ilma, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min sharri nafsi, wa min sharri kulli dabatin, anta akhidhun bi nasiyatiha, inna rabbi ala sirati mustaqim. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever reads these words in the morning, no calamity can befall him till the evening. I read these words in the morning, and then how can a calamity befall on Abu Darda when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said no calamity can befall him? Look at the hadith of Bayhaqi. This was the level of iman. When Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes to Mi'raj, to the seven heavens and above, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam returns, and the mushrikeen and the politics of Makkah cause the post, people become murtad, people leave the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They come to Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, the friend of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to test his iman and to rock the boat, and they come and say, oh Abu Bakr, your friend claims that he covered a journey which normally takes a month. He covered this journey in part of a night. In part of a night, he went all the way from Makkah al-Mukarramah to Jerusalem, to Baitul Maqdis, and then to the seven heavens and above, and he returned. Do you believe him? Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu replied, this is iman. La in qal, that if my friend has said this, then he has spoken the truth. Oh Mushriko, you are saying this to Abu Bakr. By Allah, I take him to be true in things which are far greater than this. This was the level of iman. This is the same Abu Bakr that when the words of the Quran, Alif Lam Mim, ghulibatir Rum fi adna al-ardi wa min ba'di ghalabihim sayaghlibun, is revealed, that the Romans have been defeated in the near land, and after their defeat they will become victorious. This is the same Abu Bakr that when this verse of the Quran is revealed, it is revealed at such a time when nobody can even comprehend or believe or even think that the Romans will overpower the superpower of the time, and they will conquer them, because the Romans were the underdogs, the Persians were the superpower, and the politics would always side with the superpower, the Persians of the time, because they were all idol worshippers. Sayyidina Abu Bakr, when this verse of the Quran is revealed, such is the level of iman that he goes to the mushrikeen of Makkah and he challenges them, and he recites this verse of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that the Romans will overpower the Persians. A time will come when you will see, O mushriko, that the Romans will overpower the Persians. This was the level of iman. Look at Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. He is so ill that the likes of Abu Fudala al-Ansari come to visit him, thinking that he's on the point of death. Look at the level of iman. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu says to the likes of Abu Fudala al-Ansari, O Abu Fudala, inni lastu mayyatan min wajhi hadha, inna Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ahila ilayya alla amuta hatta umar. O Abu Fudala, you have got nothing to worry about, because Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that I am not going to die till I become an Amir. I am not going to die till I become Amir, because Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said this. I will become Amir, and thereafter I will die, just like Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. This was the level of iman. Look at the life of Abu Dharr al-Ansari. He's on his deathbed, he's in a jungle, his wife is around him, they are all alone, there is nobody inside, he is dying, his wife, she's crying, tears are flowing from his eyes. Why? Because she has no shroud, she has no kafan to give him kafan in, and there is nobody to help her. If Abu Dharr dies, there's nobody there to bury him. Look at the level of iman. Sayyidina Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala says to his wife, oh my wife, you needn't worry, because he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had prior to this informed me that Abu Dharr will die in a jungle, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that a group of believers will come and they will participate in your janazah. Oh my wife, can you not see that I am in a jungle and I'm dying in a jungle, and you will see that a group of believers will definitely come and they will offer my janazah. And it so happens, just like Abu Dharr says, a group of believers come and they offer Sayyidina Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu janazah, and they bury him. This was the level of iman, because this is what the Quran demands. demanded. This is what the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam demanded. Sujood became the level of iman. That when the likes of Harith ibn Malik were asked by Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كيف أصبحت يا Harith? O Harith, how did the morning fast? He replied, Ya Rasulallah, mu'min and hakam, as a true believer. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ قَوْلٍ حَقِيقَةٌ فَمَا حَقِيقَةُ مَا تَقُولُ. O Harith, everything has a reality. What is the reality behind what you say? He replied, Ya Rasulallah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have secluded myself from the dunya. During the day I fast, during the night I stay awake, and such has become of me as if I can see the arsh of the Almighty Allah. Such has become of me as if I can see the people of Jannah visiting one another in Jannah. Such has become of me as if I can see the people of hell being punished and crowding one another, crowding beside one another in the fire of hell. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Anta imra'un nawwar Allahu qalbak arafta falzam. O Harith, you are such a man whose heart Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has illuminated. You have come to know, you have recognized, and you stay by this. Such became the level of iman that the whole world could go on one side, but in spite of this, they were not prepared to leave one teaching of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The whole world could gang upon them, and pressure could be applied from all directions. The world, in spite of its vastness, could become tired of them. But in spite of this, they were not prepared to leave one teaching of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam leaves this world, and the Muslims are shocked. The Muslims cannot believe what has happened. They're in a state of shock. They're panicking. The enemy is on the increase. People are becoming murtad left, right and center, and leaving the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hypocrites are causing problems. On top of this, the Sahaba are saying to Sayyidina Abu Bakr, O Abu Bakr, the army unit under the leadership of Sayyidina Usama, which Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent himself, stop this army unit. My brothers, such was the level of iman of Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, that in spite of all this worldly pressure and all this that was going against Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, oh, pressure that if it was on the mountains would crack. He says to the Sahaba and he says to the Muslims, لو جرت الكلاب بأرجل أزواج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما رددت شيئا وجهه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that even if dogs were to come and took out the feet of the wife of Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, Abu Bakr would not stop the army unit which he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has dispatched himself. Now moving on to the reason as to why I chose this title and the reason this introduction was mentioned. We were the lucky ones. We were the lucky ones out of all the people that have ever existed, right from Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, right to the day of judgment. We were the lucky ones and we were the fortunate ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with this gift of iman. And we received this gift without any effort. We received it without crying. We received this gift without begging the Almighty Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose us out of the millions. And the reason the Almighty Allah chose us is because the Almighty Allah loved us. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُؤْتِ الْمَالَ مَنْ يُحِبْ وَمَنْ لَا يُحِبْ وَلَا يُؤْتِ الْإِيمَانِ إِلَّا مَنْ أَحَبْ فَإِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا أَعْطَاهُ الْإِيمَانِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it comes to pound notes and the queen's pound notes, He gives them to anyone. Those He likes, those He does not like. But when it comes to iman, He does not give it to anyone. He gives it to those He loves. When He loves a person, He gives them iman. You were the lucky ones that received this gift of iman, and you received it because He loved you. You knew the value of iman. You knew what this iman was worth. You knew nothing can touch it. You knew nothing can equal it. You knew a universe full of diamonds would look silly before it. Why? Because this is the key to Jannah. This is the key to eternal success. This is the key to the pleasure of the Almighty Allah. I ask, when you knew that this is the difference between heaven and hell, and you knew that this is the key to the pleasure of Allah, and you knew that this is the key to salvation and Jannah, then why is it after September the 11th you were prepared to sacrifice this gift and this iman which is priceless for nuts? It was the first test of your life living in a minority in a Western society. You were never tested before this. I was never tested before this. It was the first test of our lives, and we failed this test. We were not beaten. We were not persecuted. We were not tormented. Bullets didn't come flying at us. Daisy cutters and these bombs didn't land on our houses. The brains of our children and their skulls were not used as footballs. Our mothers and our daughters were not raped before our very own eyes. All that happened was there was a little pressure. It was applied in the form of the news. It was applied in the form of the media. It was applied in the form of the radio station. All there was a little pressure. Islam was being ridiculed. Islam was being mocked. And all of a sudden, you wanted to disassociate yourself from certain teachings of Islam.